Hey, hello. My name is Zhang Jilun, and I'm currently studying in the School of Computer Science and Engineering in UESTC as a PhD candidate. So today, I would like to share in the campus life in UESTC and in the School of Computer Science and Engineering. And if you interest in the part of undergraduate students' life and study, it will help you to know the very true life, the very vital life in our school. So let's begin. Okay, first I have two questions. The first question is, how computer science changes our life today, or we can expand that question to how computer science and electronic engineering changes our life. Because you know, electronic engineering is also a top major or top technology in our school, in our university. Okay, so I would like to provide you two examples. The first example is every day you wake up, you turn on your smartphone, you will get information in your smartphone applications like TikTok, like Facebook, or in China. In China, you will use the Weibo. You see, almost today, the way or the almost the only way to censor the world, to censor your world you want to know, you want to explore, is by the information delivery system. So we can say that the information delivery system, like some saying TikTok, very cool, some saying Facebook, Weibo, is the involved eyes for 21st century human. And the second example is that if you want to live in your life, you want to shopping, you want to eat, you want to transport. Today, almost the only way to live in the world is to get convenience from the life assistance system of all these electronic information applications, like such like Amazon and Alibaba, Taobao. So you can see, I would like to call these applications as involved arm and feet for 21st century human. You see, someone always said that human are stopped in evolution in the 21st century, but I would say not, because the evolution progress are changed by the development of technologies and science. So you see, above all these examples, the web applications and the mobile applications are created by the technologies such like programming, database, web developments, and designing of user interface. All these technologies you will learn in the UESTC, you will learn in our school. The second question is, we may think that computer science is vital, is so vital for 21st century. Why? Why? I will provide you three pictures. These three pictures are the key to the next or 10 years, 15 years, or 100 years. The first is the Tesla AI have published the humanoid robot last month. And the self-driving cars are very popular today and tomorrow. And our manufacturing are more and more intelligent. So from today, in the 21st century, if we want to search some ways to making progress on the least, you see, if we want to make money, we want to express our ideas. We want to beat the COVID-19. We want to reconstruct all the environment. We want everyone on the earth to have a better life. You see, for more, we want to push forward the limits of humanity. If we want to achieve this, the computer science and the electronic engineering cannot be ignored. So why is computer science is so vital? Because the ability of catch, storage, analyze information are the primary productive forces in this century. So this is the importance of this. After these questions, I would introduce you the SCSE, our school. First, I would introduce the development of our school. You see, from the 1956, the established of a computer major in USDC to now, to 2015, the established of a cybersecurity in SCSE. The SCSE is the most non-history school in UESTC, even in the area of computer science in China. Next, you can see the situation of 14 members of our school are very high class. Almost all members have doctoral degree of our teachers, and nearly 19% of our members have overseas experience. Next, I'll show you the discipline ranking of our school. For this year, in the rank of global top 30s in US News, our major computer science reached the 16, and very important that our artificial intelligence major was reached the top 10 rank in US News. This is very cool. And we are reaching the top 1,000 in the global top 100 in ESI rank. Next, I'll show you the academic research of our school. Academic research is very important for students, not only for graduated students and PhD. You see, the academic research is the power of our students and our teachers. It is a total score. So if you are interested in undergraduate study, you may also pay attention to that. So you see, first is our research fields in the SCSE. We covered almost all the research fields in the computer science. You see, in the left, we can see the multimedia, computer vision. We can see the data mining, complex data processing. More importantly, you can see the machine learning, the hot words in the internet. And on the right, you can see the embedded system. You can see the computer network and IoT. This is more hardware. This is more hardware. You see, any computer or information system are combined by software and hardware. If you take part in our school, you will learn the both side knowledges of the of these research fields. And then we have high class research platforms. We have 3 national research platforms, 5 provincial ministerial research platforms, and 3 research centers of UESTC. And these research platforms covers many research fields above. Okay, next, by these research platforms, by our power of research, by our good students and excellent teachers, we are rich many, many high quality research, and we publish it in the international journal and conference. Next, I'll show you the teaching and the supervision situations of our school. From last year, we have more than 200 PhD students in our school. We have 1,200 full-time master students, and we have nearly 2,000 undergraduate students, and it covered 6 majors, and we have nearly 200 international students. So by our progress, by our good students, we have many great achievements in science and technology, both in science and technology, in the innovation activities among country and international. And next, I'll introduce the undergraduate activities you may most interested in. You see, we are not only study in our school, we are live in our school, we are live in the campus, we're living in the Chengdu city, so we have many chance to experiencing, like we will visit a temple during the autumn, we have trip to the Asian town near Chengdu city, and we have trip to Anren Asian town, and in school, in campus, we will have singing in Chinese competition, we have our own football team, and we can get Chinese cooking season. Next, I think this is the most important is the curriculum details. Okay, you see the undergraduate years is 4 years. In the first year, you will learn the math. You see the purple colored is the math. Math is very important, and you will learn the basic technology, the basic thesis in computer science, where I was blue colored this course. You will learn the programming, the C programming, and the data structure and the algorithms. And then the second year, you will continue to learn the mathematics, and you have many technologies and major skills should learn, like digital logic design, like database, like computer network and operating systems. This is the key parts of the roots of computer science. And the third year, you see, you get advanced. You should learn many state-of-the-art technologies in computer science. You will know the artificial intelligence. You can build the neural network of yourself. And you will learn the microprocessor, the assembler language and interface. You will know the cloud computing, and you will have the chance to create a robot. And for the last, you will have your graduation project. This project will include all the skills you have learned throughout the 4 years. And I think that will be very cool and happy. Okay, for the end, I'll show you a number. The number is more than 65% of our students choose to continue study for a master. This is a very big number among the country. Okay, so the rest of the students went to work in many fields. You see, every field needs the CS people. Every field needs the IT people. So you see, you can choose the computer science major. You can choose the electronic engineering major. The both are very good and very cool because where information and electronic technology are needed. Then the students, the computer graduates are needed. So this is my talk. Thank you.